I began to learn more about the other creatures that shared the forests with the chimpanzees. There were four kinds of monkeys, in addition to the baboons, and many smaller animals, such as squirrels and mongooses. There was also a whole variety of nocturnal, nighttime creatures. Porcupines and civets, creatures looking rather like raccoons, and all manners of rats and mice. Only a very few animals in the forests at Gombe were potentially dangerous, mainly buffalo and leopards. Bush pigs can be dangerous too, but only if you threaten them or their young. And of course, there are poisonous snakes, seven different kinds. Once, as I arrived on the peak in the early morning before it was properly light, I saw the dark shape of a large animal looming in front of me. I stood quite still. My heart began to beat fast, for I realized it was a buffalo. Many hunters fear buffalo more than lions or elephants. By a lucky chance, the wind was blowing from him to me, so he couldn't smell me. He was peacefully gazing in the opposite direction and chewing his cud. He hadn't heard my approach. Always, I try to move as quietly as I can in the bush. So, though I was only 10 yards from him, he had no idea I was there. Very slowly, I retreated. Another time, as I was sitting on the peak, I heard a strange mewing sound. I looked around, and there, about 15 yards away, a leopard was approaching. I could just see the black and white tip of its tail above the tall grass. It was walking along the little trail that led directly to where I sat. Leopards are not usually dangerous unless they have been wounded. But I was frightened of them in those days, probably as a result of my experience with the leopard and the wolfhound 2 years before. And so, very silently, I moved away and looked for chimps in another valley. Later, I went back to the peak. I found that, just like any cat, that leopard had been very curious. There, in the exact place where I had been sitting, he had left his mark, his droppings. Most of the time, though, nothing more alarming than insects disturbed my vigils on the peak. It began to feel like home. I carried a little tin trunk up there. In it, I kept a kettle, some sugar and coffee, and a tin mug. Then, when I got tired from a long trek to another valley, I could make a drink in the middle of the day. I kept a blanket up there, too. And when the chimps slept near the peak, I slept there, so that I could be close by in the morning. I loved to be up there at night, especially when there was a moon. If I heard the coughing grunt of a leopard, I just prayed and pulled the blanket over my head.
I just want to go back up right here because there's a footnote, and I want you to make sure that we looked at the footnote. So this footnote says, previously, Goodall saw a leopard kill a large hunting dog. So this is kind of like a flashback of why she was so frightened